Today, I'm going to talk you through the most common causes of pain at the back of your knee. We're going to take you through them individually, which one are most likely depending on your age, depending on the type of injury, and we're going to give you some tips on each on how to get them better. So, there are multiple structures at the back of the knee, and let's delve into which ones might be causing your pain. One of the most common types is a Baker's cyst, so that's a pocket full of fluid that sits at the back of the knee. With this condition, you can often palpate or press on that swelling at the back of your knee, and it will feel different than the opposite side. Patients often report that it feels tight at the back of the knee when they try to straighten it, and also when they sit back onto their heels or when they go into a deep knee bend, so that might be crouching down or squatting down, they feel pressure at the back of the knee and they might not have the full range of motion because that fluid is in the way. Often a Baker's cyst is primarily caused by something else, so it's usually a symptom of another cause. And identifying that is one of the primary aims of a clinician when a patient comes in with a Baker's cyst. However, in the meantime, you can do simple stretches such as calf stretches and hamstring stretches, and that often offloads the pressure on the back of the knee and gives some symptom relief. And here are two prime examples of how we would carry them out.
Leg, drop his heel down until he feels a stretch. Stay there for the desired amount of time.
Sit on the edge of a bed or a chair. Put your legs straight out in front with your toe pointing towards the floor. And then with a straight body, reach down towards it and hold.
The next most common cause of pain at the back of your knee is osteoarthritis. So we know that osteoarthritis is more prevalent in an older population. Typically, we look at pain in the back of the knee, stiffness when we get out of bed first thing in the morning. That usually eases within 5 to 10 minutes of getting moving. Often, if we sit for long periods of time and get up and move again, you get that ache or stiffness in the back of the knee. And it tends to be more of a general ache than a sharper pain, unless it's deteriorated significantly. Often we see osteoarthritis alongside a Baker's cyst, so it may be the arthritis within the knee that stimulates the cyst, so the swelling at the back of the knee, so you can have that swelling and stiffness when the two conditions coexist. Another common cause of pain at the back of the knee is a medial meniscus tear. So your meniscus is a spongy type of cartilage that sits in the middle of your knee. It acts as a shock absorber and helps with the congruency of the joint. We can get two types of primary issues with your meniscus. So we can get an acute tear as a result of a sudden movement. So that can be a twist or a turn or getting up from a deep knee bend position, so such as kneeling down or crouching. And that causes a sudden tear of the meniscus, usually resulting in an immediate onset of pain. Or pain that might develop within 24 hours afterwards, some swelling, and not only is the pain at the back of the knee, it's often towards the inside of the knee as well. With severe symptoms of a meniscus tear, you might get locking and instability of the joint. So as you move the joint, it just gets a little bit caught on the tear, and that's one of the most prevalent symptoms for medial meniscus tear. While on the other hand, we can get degenerative small tears in the meniscus over time. So we know as we get older, similar to arthritis, we get changes in the meniscus structure, and sometimes we can get an overload of one of these tears, and that's what we'd classify as a degenerate tear, which causes this dull ache, stiffness and pain on the back towards the inside. Normally, again, it can coexist with the previous two conditions that we talked about, and generally the main difference between them is that the pain is slightly more towards the inside and you may get locking and instability alongside that stiffness and pain. A ligament injury that can cause these symptoms is a tear to the ACL or PCL. It's much easier to differentiate between a ligament tear and the other three conditions that we talked about because there's a definitive cause of injury. So that's often a hyperextension, a sudden rotation of valgus force to the knee, and that causes stretch on the ligament resulting in a tear or complete rupture. And we see that most often in sports like skiing, where there's an extremely high prevalence, or at any change of direction sports such as football, squash, tennis, anything that involves moving, changing direction at speed. Often this causes a certain type of swelling in the knee where the whole knee tends to blow up, so you get swelling all around the knee, and it can give a dull ache at the back of the knee as well, and it usually coexists alongside instability, so that's giving way innocuously, and we typically see that when you're like getting out of a car, when you're turning on the knee, it can just buckle underneath you without giving you any warning. If you get these symptoms alongside a mechanism of injury, there's a higher likelihood that your back of knee pain may be coming from an ACL or PCL tear. Some of the less common causes of injuries at the back of the knee can be a popliteal tendon tear or tendinopathy or a popliteal artery entrapment. So first of all, with a tendon tear, you can get this irritation of the tendon through overload. So if you're doing repetitive rotation motions with your knee in a fixed position primarily, it can overload the tendon at the back of your knee, and often that can irritate your Baker's cyst as well. So you can get a coexisting tendinopathy and Baker's cyst. Normally with the tendinopathy, it fits a pattern of a little bit irritable when you start to move the knee, then it improves as you get going, but often it's worse after activity. With popliteal artery entrapment, you can get pain behind the knee that goes down into the calf muscle, and that's the result of an impingement or something pressing on the popliteal artery that leads to a reduced blood flow in the back of the leg, and this can give you a throbbing sensation or cramping sensation. We often see it as exercise induced, so the more exercise you do, your symptoms become more prevalent, and sometimes we see it at night, and that's the result of reduced blood pressure that irritates the artery and gives you your symptoms. So hopefully based on that information, you're able to differentiate between all of these conditions that can cause pain at the back of the knee. However, if you have some questions, please leave them in the comments section below, and if you haven't found the video helpful, please like and subscribe to the channel.